What is up, designers? In today's tutorial, we'll create this flat character illustration from scratch using Illustrator CC. To make things more interesting, I won't start with a sketch, so let's jump right into Illustrator where you can create a square document. You know what I'm going to do next, go to view, disable snap to pixel, take on the pen tool and start with the eye since that's the first thing we're gonna do. We'll only need an outline for that. Let's choose the 10 point round the brush, which is in the default brushes panel. Try to keep this as simple as possible. Clicking and dragging allows you to adjust the curvature of the path. If you want to deselect, hit V and click outside. The character we're doing is a girl that wears glasses, so the eyes are very important. Don't worry about adding too many details. The facial features, which includes the eyes, nose and mouth, should be defined by simple lines. I want to mention that this video celebrates 1 year since I started doing tutorials, so I want to take the chance to thank every single person that hit the like button, commented and subscribed. Honestly, you guys are the reason I do this and I really hope that these tutorials help you. So back to the tutorial with the rim of the glasses selected. Make sure to click on the reflect tool, put a point on the far right and while holding down the Alt key, make a duplicate of that rim. The face outline you're seeing is there just to give some perspective. We'll need to create a new one in a bit. As always, if you want to download the vector illustration for free and try to follow along with what I'm doing, the link is in the description of this video. Always try to exaggerate things. Even if the glasses were kind of big, try to make them bigger. For the face, start with kind of an oval shape and slant the pad that's at the top of it. Then do the hair. I have no idea what shape this is, but it's kind of wavy. Right click on it and send it to the back once you're done. Play around by assigning different shades of gray to each shape. You can then take the smooth tool and go over the pads that are curved to make them look even better. Here and there, give the character some personality. In this case, I'm adding a hair knot at the top and avoid making the details of the face very symmetrical. If you'll notice, those elements are a bit skewed. I would like for the bottom part of the hair to have the same angle as the face, so I'll draw a path and make it bigger. Don't forget to hit the Shift and Alt key at the same time to keep the same angle. Move it down a bit till you find a spot that looks good. Using the Direct Selection tool, move those anchors down a bit, and this way when you will select both the line and the hair, you'll be able to remove the bottom part using the Shape Builder tool. Let's find it in the toolbar panel, select it, and while holding down the Alt key, remove that part. To balance things out, I suggest creating a shape that looks like a shirt, in this case a simple triangle, but it can be an oval shape as well, it's up to you. I'm trying to make this flat illustration a bit more interesting by adding sharp corners next to wavy ones. That's why I'll add these weird shapes in the background. It's finally time to add some colors. You can start with some basic ones that are in the swatches panel and adjust them till you're happy. For this illustration, try to limit yourself to just a couple of colors, and since I'm Romanian, those colors will be red, yellow and blue. If you'd like to use this color scheme, I'll share it along with the vector files and you can find all of those in the description of this video. Save those colors in the swatches panel and now I can assign them to the eyes and to the nose. I kind of forgot about the ear, so make sure to select it and using the Eyedropper tool sample the whiteness next to it. Switch colors around till you find a good balance and add any element you might think of. In this case, a simple pin on the right hand side, and I think we're ready to see the final result and how we actually got here. We started off with the pen tool and drew the facial features. We then defined the shape of the face and the hair. We added a background shape and finished it off by assigning colors to those shapes. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more. Thank you again for being part of this amazing community of creatives. Until next time, take care. Bye.